This is a Bluetooth speaker. In today's video, I will show you exactly how I designed, 3D printed, and built this device so you can do it too right at home. Besides Bluetooth connectivity, you can control it with these buttons or this infrared remote. I will also share how I painted the enclosure to achieve this stunning wood look, taking your 3D printed projects to the next level. Let me take a moment to explain how I came up with this project and why I chose to 3D print the enclosure. Bluetooth speakers have fascinated me for quite some time. There is something about understanding how electronic devices work and figuring out how to build them that has sparked my curiosity. Not long ago, I started watching YouTube videos of people building their own Bluetooth speakers. They inspired me to give it a shot. At first, I tried building enclosure using PVC pipes, which I saw in many tutorials. It's a great method for people who are good at crafting, but unfortunately, that is not me. My PVC attempt was, well, let's just say it failed miserably. I moved on and got hooked on wooden enclosures. Wood tends to provide much better sound quality than plastic. However, shaping wood to create the right structure is not easy, especially when you live in an apartment and can't cut, sand, or drill wood at home. After rolling all those materials, I decided that whenever enclosure are built, it had to be made with the help of a machine. I initially turned to laser cutting and ended up assembling a Bluetooth speaker from MDF. You can check out this tutorial here on my channel. Even though I got decent results, I wasn't satisfied. This time, I wanted to take things further and try something new, 3D printing. I had played around with 3D printers a few years ago, but only for simple projects. Designing and printing a more complex structure like this one felt like a fun challenge. So, I watched several 3D printer tutorials on YouTube, opened Fusion 360 and started sketching. Honestly, I had a great time designing the enclosure, drawing shapes, extruding them into 3D objects, painting, and moving them around to create the speaker I envisioned was a blast, and I want to do it more times in the future. Talking about 3D printing reminds me of the sponsor for today's video, Electro. Electro makes life easier for makers by offering a wide range of services, from manufacturing to selling electronic components. With over 10 years of experience and thousands of satisfied customers, Electro is the perfect partner for your next project. For this speaker, I uploaded my STL files to Electro's website and used their 3D printing service. I choose photosensitive resin as my material, but they offer 12 different options depending on your needs. After placing my order, Electro shipped the parts straight to my door, fast and hassle-free. Electro delivers to over 150 countries thanks to their shipping partnerships. Whether you need 3D printing, PCB, manufacturing, assembly, or even help selling your product, Electro has affordable solutions for every step of the process. Sign up with the link in the description below to explore all they have to offer. Thank you, Electro, for sponsoring this video and supporting the small creators like me. Now, back to the project. While designing the enclosure, I frequently referred to the measurements of my electronic components to ensure everything would fit perfectly. It looked great on paper, but reality had other plans. I initially designed and ordered these custom parts from Electro. However, if you compare them to the final assembly, you'll notice some key differences. One of the early design decisions was to add a logo on the back of the enclosure to give it a more professional look. Unfortunately, that idea didn't quite pan out. When I tried fitting the parts together, the back wall broke under pressure. This led me back to the drawing board to redesign and reprint the back panel. While updating the back panel, I also decided to rethink the screw placement. In the original version, the holes were slightly smaller than my screws, making assembly difficult. Instead of just resizing the rows, I opted to eliminate the screws entirely for a cleaner and simpler design. With the enclosure finally sorted out, it's time to dive into the heart of this project, the electronics. Here's what you need to build this project. Number 1. Bluetooth plus Amplifier Module. I used the Kebidu 5W 2-channels module, which offers a ton of features for its price. It supports Bluetooth, FM radio, SD cards, and USB drives. It also includes an infrared remote and physical buttons for added convenience. Number 2. Speakers. You'll need 2 5W 4-ohm speakers with a 40mm diameter. Mine are generic, imported from China, and you can use them too. Number 3. Battery. To power the system, I recommend two 18650 LiPo batteries connected in parallel. The Kebidu module operates between 3.7 and 5 volts, so this setup is ideal. Number 4, charger module. I use a TP4056 charger module with a USB Type-C port. This module connects to the battery and then powers the amplifier. It allows for safe charging and reduces the chances of battery damage. Number 5, passive radiators. To boost the best response, I added two 66mm passive S radiators. This component reverberates at low frequencies, enhancing the depth of sound without the need for dedicated woofers or subwoofers. When researching passive radiators, I came across a common rule of thumb. The total surface area of the radiators should be about 1.5 to 2 times greater than the surface area of the speakers. While this is a good starting point, is not the whole story. Later on, we will explore why this rule isn't entirely accurate and what other factors you need to consider when choosing the right passive radiators. And 6. Other materials. There are materials we use, but they don't require a deep explanation. 2 3mm LEDs, super glue, 2mm EVA foam sheets for sound insulation, paints and brushes for finished enclosure. You'll find a full materials list in the description below. Definitely check them out. Once you have your components ready, it's time to start assembling the electronics system. Step number 1. Modifying the charger module. Let's start by modifying the charger module. The TP4056 module comes with a 2 built-in LEDs, one for charging and one for full charge. Since these LEDs will be inside the enclosure, I replaced them with external 3mm LEDs for better visibility. To do this, I desoldered the built-in LEDs and soldered wires connecting the 3mm LEDs. No resistors are needed, as the module already includes 1K1 ballast resistors. Step number 2. Connecting the components. Next, I soldered the batteries to the charger module and connected the TP4056 to the amplifier module. Then, I soldered the speakers to the amplifier. The wire is straightforward. Refer to these schematics on screen for clarity. Once the electronic system was assembled, I tested it by pairing the Bluetooth module with my phone. Everything worked and the sound was decent, but I knew it would sound much better once the enclosure was finished. Speaking of it, let's move on to designing and finishing the enclosure. Here are the 3D printed pieces that Electro sent me. The fit was pretty good, but the plain white finish wasn't visual appealing, so we are going to paint them. To achieve this wooden look finish, spray the enclosure with caramel colored spray paint. If you are in the US, rust oleum warm caramel is a great option. Outside the US, find a similar shade. I used a local light brown spray. The lighter, the better. Once the paint dries, use copy ink refills, E57, E59, and E07, and a brush to create a wood grain texture the same way I'm doing on this clip. Last but not least, paint the back panel black or print it from black filament. After painting everything, line the inside of the enclosure with 2mm EVA foam sheets to reduce vibrations and improve sound quality. With the enclosure ready, the final step is putting everything together. With the electronics, radiators, and full aligned panels ready, it's time to assemble everything inside the enclosure. I placed each component, ensuring there was no air leaks. Once satisfied, I glued everything in place, and with that, the Bluetooth speaker was complete. Or so I thought. Excited to test it, I poured it on. The sound quality was decent, but something immediately stood out. The bass radiators weren't moving. I cranked the volume up to maximum, yet they didn't move. Not even by a millimeter. Confused, I turned to Reddit for answers, sharing my build and the issue I was facing. To my surprise, I received dozens of responses filled with insights and questions. It quickly became clear that solving the radiator problem would likely require a complete redesign. The most plausible explanation? The speakers I used were simply too small to generate enough air pressure to move the radiators, and the radiators themselves were too heavy for these speakers. Several helpful users point me toward books and software tools that can guide me better design choices for future speaker projects. So, how do you choose the right passive radiators for your project? Here are a few key tips I've learned. Number 1. match the radiator size and weight to your speakers. If the radiator is too heavy, your speaker won't have enough air pressure to move it. Number 2, use surface area guideline as a starting point. A common rule of thumb is to aim for passive radiators with a total surface area of 1.2 to 2 times greater than that of your speaker's cone. However, this depends on other factors like the displacement and enclosure volume. Number 3. Considering tuning frequency and compliance, use software tools like WIN, ISD, or passive radiators calculators to determine the optimal tuning frequency and therefore the best radiators for the project. It relies on the driver's specifications, the enclosure's internal volume, and the radiator mass. Number 4. Avoid air leaks. Any air leak in the enclosure can affect performance, so ensure a perfect seal. Different enclosure types, sealed versus vented, may also affect your choice of radiators. I will definitely apply these tips and explore the recommended resources for my next build, but for now, I've decided to keep things as they are. This journey was filled with trial and error, but I learned so much along the way, and that's what makes this project so rewarding. I can't emphasize enough how beautiful this Bluetooth speaker looks. Combining a caramel spray with copper ink riffles was a fantastic idea. A big thank you to Off-Earth for sharing their tutorial on creating wood-like textures for 3D printed objects. It really brought this project to life. This was a fun project despite the challenge with the back wall and passive radiators. I learned so much and can't wait to use this experience to design even better speakers in the future. Now, the model we'll be waiting for. How does it sound? Listen to this.
You stole my heart of gold after my silver soul. Can you dig any deeper now? I gave you all I know, put you on this golden roof, but I'm a little stronger now. You cashed in on my promises, you know I'm too generous. Now I've learned to never help you out, 'cause I'm done cleaning up your mess. Found myself in my regrets. I've become a little stronger now. A little stronger now.
The audio is clear and fills the room with rich sound, creating an enjoyable experience for listeners. Even with its flaws, I am thrilled with how these Bluetooth speakers turn out. The wood-like finish gives it a premium look, and the sound quality is a big step up from my last build. Overall, I think it's a great project and you should definitely give it a try. I uploaded the STL files so you can download and use them for free. If you are interested in this design, check the link in the description. If you enjoyed this project, please like this video, subscribe to the channel and share it with your friends. For more do-yourself tutorials, be sure to check out this next video.